London with the dog daddy. Yay!
Perfect.
Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. It's the Dog Daddy and today I'm here visiting the UK and I will be bringing you guys along on this journey to where I go and meet a lot of my clients in the UK to help them with some of the dog's behavior issues. And I'm going to explain in this video a lot of what goes on in the short videos that you guys see. And a lot of you guys have been asking a lot of questions in regards to the training process. And I'm going to cover all that in this video, as well as vlogging my way through England. I actually flew into London, but I have traveled by train to a lot of different parts of England to help different clients. So it's been a pretty fun adventure and pretty crazy adventure as well. And I'm going to show you guys all of that. And I want to thank you guys so much for, I cannot believe we're at 600,000 subscribers now, which is so insane. We're growing so fast. And as you can hear me, I have a microphone. So now that I have so many people watching, I think it's time for me to really take it a little bit more serious. It's microphones are cheap. It's not a matter of that. It's just that I just go out and I do my training. I do my thing. I don't really look at myself as like a YouTuber. But now I, might as well start because we're gaining about 10,000 people a day and consistently. And so I think very soon we're going to be at 1 million. And I know you guys want to hear more of what I'm doing and learn a little bit more. So if this helps you guys be able to hear what I'm doing in my trainings and what I'm saying, then that's a good thing. Let's get started with this video. You guys are going to see a lot of dogs, a lot of traveling, and all around London and other parts of England. Hello, just testing the audio to see if you guys can hear me from the new microphone. Hopefully.
This one on?
Harrods. Alright, we're just getting a taxi. Where are we headed to?
Harrods.
To eat. We're going to get some food. We're now going to eat over here. At least though, it feels good in here. So for you guys who like chocolate, this would be heaven for you. I have never seen so much chocolate in my life before. You guys have seen a lot of my short videos, and there's a lot of speculation on what is really going on in the short videos. Are they real? Are just real clients, real dogs that I'm training? And in this video, towards the end, I'm going to feature one particular dog training session in the UK that I did with a very fearful dog, and I'm going to go very deep in details on what was going on there. But just so you know, these videos are real, the trainings are real, the results are completely real. What you guys don't understand is that these training sessions are very long. My shortest sessions are 2 hours long, and on average, the group trainings last between 3 to 5 hours. So the owners get a lot of information, a lot of homework, and a lot of knowledge, and a lot of explanation on what's going on and getting to know their dogs better. And so the results you guys see are usually from the first few minutes of the training, and the rest is just repetition, 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 in addition to a lot of extra information for the owners to get to understand their dogs. And that's why my training is really effective for those owners who are dedicated to training their dogs, because the results are right there. They see that it works. They realize that they just have to follow through with what I show them, because I show them results right away. I have trained about 1,000 new dogs this year in 2022 so far. I have done about 50 group training sessions in about 40 different cities around the world. You guys are watching a training session here in London, in the UK. Another thing that a lot of people don't understand is that I do deliver really great results to all my clients. But that doesn't mean that just because the dogs improve so much in a training session that they're completely trained. However, my clients are also not misled to think that. They do completely understand that they have a lot of homework to do in order to completely change the dog's behavior and completely have their dogs trained. The main difference is when they come to my training session, they can expect major results. They can expect something that makes sense for them and for the dogs. And they can expect that they will have the right tools and the right knowledge to actually make the right progress with their dogs. And I guarantee that, and I give them that. And that's why I have a very high satisfaction rate with my clients, because they leave with no further questions. I answer all their questions. I explain things over and over and over again, and they leave with results. They leave understanding that I can get every single one of their dogs to behave. So therefore, they just have to learn to do the same thing that I'm doing in order to keep those results coming and continue to improve their dog's behaviors. If you keep watching, I'm still going to cover one particular dog that I trained in the UK last week, and I'm going to explain a lot of what was going on with that dog, because it's one of the vital videos that I make, the short videos, and you guys don't get to see, you know, the full training session, which lasts, again, about 2 to 5 hours, and the video is shrinked down to 1 minute, still making it very real. It's one training session. The results are real. I don't try to say that the dog, all that is done in 1 minute, but of course it's all in one training session. But I'm going to kind of slow down and explain what was going on with that dog. And that's just one little example of the many dogs that I have trained. But if you guys like this video, I'm going to do a lot more of that, so you guys can get you understand what goes on in these training sessions and why my clients are so satisfied with the training. Here I am in London, traveling throughout the city. We're about to go through other parts of the UK very soon to meet my other clients. And during those training sessions, I'm going to explain to you guys what was going on. But I wanted to show you guys around what I was seeing, what I was doing, what I was up to. I was in the UK for 1 week. I'm traveling everywhere this year. The next stop is Columbus, Ohio on August 6th. And then I'm going to San Diego and Los Angeles, August 13th and 14th. And I'm going to Sydney, Australia, and then right after that, Chicago, Illinois. And that concludes the month of August. But you guys can go to my website at dogdaddywithtwoys.com and check out the whole schedule and buy your tickets for my training sessions. I'm getting a train right now and we're going to one of my private clients, and I'll see you guys there. I just got to Durham. It's raining here. It was nice weather in London. It's 3.5 hours away. Now I have to find my client who is picking me up here for me to go to their house and help them with their German Shepherd. Sit. Good girl. I'm gonna take her muzzle off.
Okay.
That's a good girl.
Good girl.
Molly, sit. Right down. That's a good girl. Good.
Okay, so remind me where I am again.
You're in County Durham, northeast of England. About 3 hours train ride from London.
So I flew all the way to London and
you did.
Took a train and
yep.
Specifically to help this girl right here. So what is it that is going on with your dog?
She doesn't like visitors to the house at all. If you come in the house, she will go ballistic. She will try and bite you. She will lunge. She will pull. She will grumble. She will growl. And she might even just crap herself if
yeah.
you get too close.
She gets really afraid of people.
Yeah, if you try and touch her, she'll definitely bite. Or she'll try and bite.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't trust her with people at all.
How old is she?
She's 2. She was 2 last month.
Has she always been really afraid of people like that?
No, I think it started at the vets when she was about maybe 12 weeks old. COVID and PPE and overdressing, face masks, face shields, flappy pinnies, big scary gloves.
Yeah.
And the vet actually picked her up and carried her off, and she wet herself all over the vet. And when she came out, she was a different dog.
And now it's been almost 2 years of that?
2 years of that, yeah.
Hmm.
We've had no visitors. We don't take her to the shop. She won't go in the shop. She just bark at everybody. We don't see anybody, basically. We found the Dog Daddy on YouTube and Facebook. And I'm a big German Shepherd fan. So obviously one day I put in YouTube, Black German Shepherds, and up came the Dog Daddy with these beautiful dogs, just like the dog I've got. And then I followed him and watched his training and was impressed. So we thought, let's give this a go. We can't do any worse than we've already got. So let's try if we can fix our little Molly. I've seen a lot of Dog Daddy's videos, yes, and they're impressive. I knew she would freak out because she hates people, she hates strangers. I knew she was going to freak, but the Dog Daddy sorted it.
So how do you feel about the beginning of the training when she was really stressed out?
It scared me. I will be honest, it scared me. And for my dog's sake, I came out of the scene and left into it. Because I think I was making my dog worse by being scared.
Did you expect that she was going to act that afraid, or that the training was going to go the way that it went in the beginning?
I didn't think she would be that afraid at all. I knew she'd be scared, but I didn't think she would go to quite the extreme she did. No, I didn't.
So when you saw that happening, why did you let me continue to do it?
Because from watching the Dog Daddy's videos, I've learned that if you push a dog through the fear, they will come out a better dog the other side. That's why I think, yes, it's got to go. It's got to happen. Because she will come out the other side a better and more comfortable dog and confident dog. And she has.
Yeah, so now that we walked to her today for the last few hours, what do you get from the training so far?
I never could walk her before. I've got very disabled hands. I struggled to hold my dog. Tonight I walked her for an hour and she was so easy. Just gentle lead and an easy dog to control.
Did you pass by people and dogs and all the distractions?
Yes, we did. First time ever, two dogs, one either side. No problem. No problem at all.
Awesome.
Happy dog mummy.
She has a, she has a long ways to go, a little
She
bit
does, yep.
practicing,
Yep.
but she made a lot of improvements, and you just have to be
I
consistent
will,
now,
yep.
because a lot of times people don't realize that. I don't claim that that when I train a dog in a day that they're fully
No,
trained.
no.
It's just that I
Yeah.
think what I try to say to my clients is that a lot of times they will have a trainer come for many months and
Yeah.
promises and nothing you ever
Yeah.
get. That's the only difference is I
Yeah.
come and I do deliver like a lot of results in one training session, but that's still not to claim that the dog is fully trained,
I know.
but I also kind of leave my clients like equipped so
Yeah, you
that they
have.
can
Yep.
continue to
Yep.
practice. And that's what makes the training really effective in the long run is that they know what to do, how
Yep.
to do it safely, and the dog is also left in a much more manageable state of mind, so it's a
Good
lot easier to
girl.
practice.
She's a good girl. Very good girl.
So I think a lot of the questions that you guys have got answered in those last few clips with the owner's comments as well as what I was saying. And I wanted to touch a little bit more on that. And a lot of times you guys don't understand that the dogs that I work with, a lot of things have been tried, thousands of dollars have been spent, multiple trainers with a lot of experience have been tried before my clients reach out to me as a last resort to help them. A dog like this does not respond to treats. She does not respond to any other type of approach. Masking the problem doesn't solve the problem. Keeping the dog living in a bubble, I like to call them, I like to call it living in a bubble because you don't really push them through their fears because you really, really have to know what you're doing when you use the approach that I use. But it is very effective. There's no arguing that. That's why I have so many clients. That's why I have such a high success rate with the dogs that I train because I know what I'm doing. But again, it's not easy. And if you don't understand it, there's room for you to learn the methods. And my clients do, they take the time to understand and learn the methods. But, trying to just judge the book by its cover in a way and try to say there's other ways, you have to consider that out of the thousands of dogs that I have trained, thousands over the years, the majority of those clients, they have tried well-known dog trainers. They have tried reputable dog trainers. These dogs, they are so difficult to work with. They require someone who really understands them. And that's beyond what most people can even comprehend. So I want to, bring that on because a dog like this, as you heard from the owner, had never been out. Had never been touched by a stranger. This is my first time meeting her here this day, and I'm here petting her. She's wagging her tail. Of course, she's going to be a little nervous. She's 2 years old. She's been avoiding people her whole life since she was 12 weeks old. And she has bitten people and she has tried to scare people away from her. And with my approach, she's starting to make progress. It doesn't mean that the dog is going to be 100% better and the most confident dog that you have ever seen. Because I see a lot of comments of people saying the dog is too afraid. The dog is clearly afraid. Of course, the dog is afraid. Of course, they are. They have been afraid for years. There's no one, no one, there's absolutely no one that's going to make the dog feel better around the things that they are normally afraid of in just one training session. The main difference is I actually make the most progress with those dogs and put them in on the right path for further success and better results in the long run. And that's not just me saying that. You can see I'm going to be putting here some testimonials from my clients. I do not ask my clients to type any type of reviews or testimonials. So every testimonial and review you guys are going to see were genuinely sent to me by my clients or commented by my clients. without me ever asking them to do so. But I'm going to add them here to kind of show you guys how they feel about the training. And I'm trying to just explain to you guys that there's a lot more to it, right? I'm not trying to pretend. I'm not trying to trick anyone. The results are real. Major progress is made, but that does not mean the dog is fully trained. However, my clients are aware of that. And that is what makes the training so effective, is because they really know what to expect and they really know what training is all about. And I want to, you know, bring that on more to you guys and let everybody know so that you have realistic expectations when you're training your dog.
Approaching Ely.
So you normally lock her over here? Here. I'm gonna put you in that down over here.
Okay.
Down. Leave it. Hello. Hello. I can speak goat to a sheep language. I'm so sorry that we don't have good audio for this video, so I'm going to just do like a little voiceover here. This is a random dog that I found at the park when I was working with my clients. And we decided to help them because he was very reactive. I could see that he was definitely out of fear. I had no idea what was going on with this dog. But I just knew that I could help him. And after talking to the owner, I found out he is an 11-year-old dog that she rescued 5 years ago. And she has not been able to stop him from being so reactive. So he's really loud, which she calls him being mad at other dogs. He goes mad and she cannot get him to stop. She tells me she has tried everything and he just gets so stressed out and he can't be around other dogs. So I'm showing her some techniques here to get his attention and correct the behavior, as well as how to encourage him to be okay around other dogs. And it is so rewarding to just stop and help a total stranger. She was so grateful. She was so excited afterwards. I was there with my clients for about an hour, and I could see her walking around the entire park, practicing with her dog after I showed her this, because it gave her a new way, you know, a new method to try, and it was really effective, and I could just see how proud she was to work with her dog around the dogs. And I was all the way in the UK, and I was helping a total stranger, and it feels so good to be able to do that. And I don't know, one little dog, he's 11 years old, and he didn't have a good start in life, and she rescued him 5 years ago. And so to know that he's going to enjoy the rest of his life a little bit more because the owner learned how to communicate with him and make him a little bit less afraid, you can't get better than that. You know, it's just like, I will carry that on for the rest of my life. It's something so small but so big at the same time. And here we go.
Good boy. How old is he again?
He's nearly 11.
11.
Oh my God, I've tried everything. Oh my word. Come on then.
All right, just keep practicing.
Okay everyone, welcome to the end of the video and the end of my trip here to England. It's been a whole journey and really fun adventure, as you guys have seen throughout this video. And I'm really blessed to be able to do this and help people that live so far away that probably never thought that I would be able to fly in and help them, you know, just some years ago. And now here I am, able to do it and making a difference so far away from home. It really feels good. And also, I'm really thankful for the opportunity to have like new experiences. As I told you guys, like I had never been on the train before, and so to take a 3+ hour first train ride in another country by myself, and then another 5 hours from there to another destination in a new country that I don't know, and that things work differently. It's, you know, it feels good at the end for pushing myself and making it happen and succeeding at the end of the day in every aspect. So we did the trip, it was successful, I was able to help the owners and the dogs, and I get to carry that experience with me now. I feel really blessed and very happy that I did it. And now it's time to go back to the US. Today is Friday, and I head to New York. I have my class there this Sunday to do some dog training. So maybe by the time you guys see this video, that will already have happened. Depending on how fast I can edit this video. But anyways, I am traveling. Next month I'm going to Australia, Sydney, Australia, for August 20th. And I have my website in the description of the video if you guys want to check it out, with a bunch of different cities that I'm already scheduled to go to. And many other cities will be added there throughout this year and next year. So definitely keep an eye out on that. And thank you so much for watching the video. Consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys in the next one.